Hello world, PDR coming at you here with a, gosh, what year is this BMW? It is a 99 BMW with a big dent on the door here. It's about that long. Starts there, goes there, has a little scratch through it, and it's right through that body line. So I'm getting it warm. 127, 126, and I've got my wedge and my guard up against the glass, nicely stuffed in there. I'm going to grab my number one tool, and I think where I'm going to start is right on that scratch and just work this body line. So let's do it. Now I'm right there, I'm just working that body line. Hopefully you guys have an angle. I'm just coming through and making some really baby pushes, because even though this is a wholesale job that we're going to do really quickly and really inexpensively, we still want to make it look nice. So, hence the heat on a dent like this. If you're attempting to do it without warming it up, you're not going to have a good result. It's about the only way I can say it. And now I'm going to come through the back part of it over here. And you can see I find my tool, and I'm just kind of making some baby pushes. They're real strong pushes, by the way. The ones I'm making, they're a hefty amount of leverage that I'm putting into this. But right when I see that metal move, I stop. So I'm not really pushing anything out at once. You get a little tighter angle on it, widen it out, come back through the front again. I know it's nice and warm, so I don't have to worry about the paint cracking. And now I'm going to go through this deepest part right here. It's going to be kind of the moment of truth, zen mode. Normally when I get real quiet, but I've been doing a lot of work today, so I can talk. This is the point in the video when I say, I sure do appreciate everybody that clicks on this video and shares it and comments and all that stuff. I really do. If you would, hit that subscribe button. It helps out the channel a lot. Yeah, we're at 118, 120, 124. Nice temperature where I want it to be. Coming back up on this front line again. And this is normally a dent that would take, oh gosh, hours. In my first 5 to 10 years, I'd have spent hours on a dent like this. But I'm just kind of following it around and finding the lows. Acting like I've been here before. I don't know what that was. That was a weird sound. Keep them kind of had a power surge. Now, this part, guys, I know that it still has a little dent to it and a little brow to it, but at this point is when I have to cross-check. I have to go down like this and bring the board up like this so it's at an angle looking into it. Okay, guys, we're back. We had to change the angle. We got a little cross-check angle. Now I can see that I've got a little bit of a low here, and obviously that bit of low right here. This bit of low right here is different than this little bit of low right here. This one on the top edge, it's gotta be brought up. And then this one on the bottom edge, it's just gotta be kind of reefed out through the middle. So I'll show you what I mean. Let's get it nice and warm. Let's heat it up, double time. We're still up to 96, 97, but hey, I only turned off that heat gun for about a minute and it cooled down. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna scoop my wedge and guard up a little bit farther, get myself an angle where I know I can come in here with number one, and I'm gonna dial in this little area. It's gonna be kinda tough for you guys to see because it's getting to that, oh, you guys might actually be able to see that. But yeah, this is where I wanna get this little edge nice and cleaned up. It's tight in there. It's not braced up or anything. It's not tight in that sense. But just the way BMW makes their cars is very tight. Yeah, that actually cleaned up pretty nice. Now I'm gonna come through the middle here and do the meat. That other part of the dent right here. But to do that, turn the board just a bit so I see a little bit different of an angle. And I'm just gonna come through and run this line on the top. Right here, go down a little bit more, and now I'm actually on that bead of that line, trying to work that body line out, right there. I know it's tough for you guys to see because I can hardly even see where my tool is. I know where my tool is just by feel, but that's when you get into this part of painless dent repair that's never ever talked about, and that's when you are doing the dent by feel, guys. Like, you know where your tip is, you can't see it, there's no way to see it, but you know that you're pushing in the right spot. And sometimes it is about confidence and trusting yourself, because sometimes you're sitting there going, I know I'm in the right spot, and I know I'm pushing the right place, but I'm not seeing anything. And it's scary because there's two ways to look at it. You could be in the wrong spot, pushing, and looking over here, but you're pushing over here. And by the time you look your head up, they've just mangled a piece of metal. So you have to know, every time you push on it, it's gonna move metal. Whether you see it or not, it's going to move metal. I put about 100 or 200 little pushes in that, and you don't see any. If you were to look real close, I see about 3 or 4 with my board of real slight ones. Now I'm gonna come through on this bottom edge until I can find my tool. There it is. And now I'm gonna make some real stout pushes through that body line. Just right on the body line itself. Just strong pushes to bring that line up. And it's starting to look pretty good for the quick little wholesale job that we're doing for it. It is a pretty car, and we do want to make it look as nice as possible. But okay, there's a little dent right back here that I didn't notice. We'll take that one out. We can even turn this off. And thank you guys for sticking around through this lengthy video. But like I say, we probably spent 5 or 6 minutes on this dent. And I used to spend an hour on something like this. So let's take a look and see what we got. Move that out of the way. And not drop it. Just looking up and down it, I'm not seeing any deviation or reflection, but that's also very close. Okay, when we get out a little bit, I think I see that scratch more than anything. I'll let the owner touch it up if he wants to, but other than that, I think it came out looking pretty darn good. I might actually make a little tap on this brow off camera, but we've had a pretty long video getting that big dent out. And we'll just leave it at that. So hit that like on the way out if you would, guys. Other than that, this has been PDR, and I'm out. Peace.